Coldplay Music of the Spheres album review. Let's chat about it. Hey guys, what's going on? John here from What's Spinning here tonight to chat about the latest from Coldplay, UK-based alternative rockers, polarizing figures to say the absolute very least. And more times than not, I'm just as frustrated with them as a lot of other people are. I will say this, though. I don't think that their debut, Parachutes, gets enough credit. I mean, it's a great album. There's some really interesting ideas in post-Britpop on here. But ever since, it's been a rocky road, man. Their follow-up, Rush of Blood to the Head, was just so heartless, so bland. Now, I will say this, and I may be in the minority here. I don't think X and Y is that bad. I actually think it's got some great singles on there. And pound for pound, Viva La Vida might be their best album. But then, by this point, honestly, Coldplay was a pop act and not really a very good one either. I mean, Miley Xylitol was a pop album, but not exactly a fascinating one. And I swear, I think Ghost Stories is the worst album that they ever put out. And trust me, A Head Full of Dreams is at a close second. I will say this, though. In 2019, they really did shock me with their Everyday Life album. This was a far left turn to what they had been putting out. This was a rustic, sort of rootsy album. It was stripped down, but what interested me here was the amazing set of influences from A to Z on this album. It also had some really great singles. I genuinely thought we were turning a corner with Coldplay and they could be into some interesting twilight years of their career, but hey, they discovered emojis. And with that being said, I think Coldplay easily just came out with the worst album of the year and a frontrunner for one of the worser ones in their catalog. We have a slew of emoji-titled tracks like Saturn or the Ring of Planet emoji as this album's intro. And I just want to know, like, who signed off on this? This is not progressive. It's not scenic. I don't know what's gotten into them. However, this track will let you think that it's progressive and scenic and forward-thinking, let me tell you. Tracks like Humankind are just tough to swallow, man. Like, it's not like they haven't toyed with big synths before. Hey, some of their better singles actually, you know, revolve around it. But this to me sounds like Coldplay signed on to do a soundtrack for a really cheesy movie and the soundtrack sucked. This chorus, while gigantic sounding, is freaking flat as anything here. Like, I'm so thrown off because their last album showed them stripping things down, back to basics, getting back to their roots, and really talking about and getting into some of their serious influence. And listen, say what you will about Coldplay, 95% of their material is not enjoyable. But I will say this, time after time after time, no matter how bad an album is that they put out, at least it has a single or two on there that I'm like, okay, yeah, if I heard this in an arena, it would probably slap. But this is not it. By the time we get to the star emoji track, honestly, I feel like crying, and not in a good way. And the heart emoji. Oh my lord, oh my lord. Not only do I think this is the worst track here, this is one of the worst tracks that I've heard all year. For a track about love and passion, none of that comes through. Oh, and we have some guests here that add nothing. We Are King and Jacob Collier make this track even more cheesy and ridiculous and heartless. I mean, say what you will, this album is probably going to be my least favorite album of the year, but even I can't deny some of the singles here, and that's what makes things even more frustrating. I think Higher Power's pretty okay. This track, while completely out there still and completely full of itself, is really catchy. Like, this may be a case of Stockholm Syndrome here, but I don't actually hate this. Like, it is almost laughably over the top at times. But this hook is really big, and they perform the hell out of this track. And truthfully, Let Somebody Go has grown on me a little bit, actually. I thought this was a bland ballad at first, but it actually has some material going for it. It's tender, it's sweet, and it's actually got some of the more interesting synth work on this album. It's really nice to hear, you know, a classy, human track. And actually, Selena Gomez here, her performance is really passionate. She's actually one of the better guests on this album. No, they have some genuine chemistry. This is nice. And People of the Pride, honestly, like, oh boy, this is certainly a guilty pleasure. This is so cheesy. This is so ridiculous and misguided. Like, this genuinely sounds like a Muse track, but like on a really bad album. There's that one single of theirs that are just like, oh wow, Muse can't even take this seriously, but I can have fun with it. That's what this is. Listen, I might be in the minority here. You might hate this. But the ever so slight edge to this track and the bulky riff is doing something for me. And you know what? Screw it. I think My Universe is a decent pop tune. Say what you will about this album. It is easily a runner-up for the worst album I've heard this year. This track is sharp as a tack, it's catchy as hell, and BTS do a great job here. I mean, yes, lyrically, this is a wasteland, and this is Coldplay branching out into dance pop, which is literally making me shake in my boots for the future. But it's very catchy. It's very catchy. But the rest of this album, Coldplay, you shouldn't have. Beautiful. Oh boy. Vocal effects. Over Chris Martin's voice. No thank you. This album is obnoxious enough as is. This doesn't make it any easier. This would have been asinine without all the bells and whistles and effects. Then we get these ridiculous vocoder vocals on top. Not feeling it, man. And this track just has nothing to fall back on. The Earth emoji track is just 20 seconds I'm never getting back in my life. And the affinity emoji, like, why am I talking about emojis? Good freaking God, Coldplay. This track's obnoxious from the word go. Earlier, I was desperate for a little upbeat instrumental and a little oomph. But this heady, ultra-colorful instrumental is like sensory overload here. Just literally getting on every nerve that I have. But not only that, this is just so entry-level. This sounds like Coldplay covering something off the Mario Kart soundtrack, throwing some vocals on top and calling it a day. No thanks, bruh. I'm good. Oh, and they are so kind. They end off this album with Coloratura, a plus 10-minute odyssey that goes nowhere, and I am baffled by it. I don't know what inspired Coldplay to write this album. I don't know what inspired Coldplay to write this track. This does not make things any easier. Forget closure. I'm more baffled now than ever. Like, I don't even want to understand this. Despite what Coldplay want you to think, this is not their magnum opus. This is not Larger Than Life. This is not even progressive. This is a major flop, a gigantic mess, and one of the worst albums I've heard all year. And you know what? Hearing Everyday Life a couple of years ago, you know, I thought it was a big turning point for the band. I thought we could expect some big, interesting things. And then I hear this. And I hear some of the singles on here. And you know what? Some of them are catchy. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to say this is a 0 out of 10 or anything like that. Because there are moments here that, you know, get my foot pumping a little bit. But there is nothing, and I mean nothing on this album, that is even close to being imaginative or groundbreaking or progressive. Coldplay, you shouldn't have. I'm feeling a strong 3 on this album, but let me know what you guys think down below. If you like the video, be sure to give us a like, give us a subscribe, and let me know down below what you would like for me to chat about in the future. And until next time, have a great day, guys.